are back in the clinic and I'm going to be showing some exercises on our equipment here. Today we're going to do some equipment of some exercises on the chair, which I haven't done on Instagram or Facebook Live yet. The chair is a really nice piece of equipment because there's lots of great exercises you can do on it, and it's small. And if you want, you can attach armbands to it so you can get even more exercises on it. But I'm gonna start over there on the chair and then move over to the reformer, and you guys can take a look and see what are some of our favorites or my favorites on these pieces of equipment. Hi, Jamie, happy birthday.
All right.
So the chair has these springs, and I'm gonna go ahead and add another spring to it. And I'm gonna start with what is oftentimes ballet dancers' favorite exercise. It's really hard to get this other ways. And I featured this a little while ago on our Instagram post. And it's nice for getting that ankle strength and foot strength that dancers need, but also obviously really important for everybody that runs, leaps, jumps. It gets your foot and your soleus working like many other exercises can't quite do without equipment. This is kind of hard to create outside of this piece of equipment, but super nice, like, unique way. Hopefully you can get, I mean, I hate to show exercises that you can't quite do, but this is a piece of equipment that's pretty accessible in that it's small and can fit in your house. I'm not saying that it's inexpensive, but it's a nice piece of equipment to have because you can do a lot on it and it can take up a big footprint. Okay. On one side, on the other side, you put the ball of my foot on the foot bar, rest my knee on the edge, and push. There is no way to compensate by using the other leg for this exercise. So you can really see where one side might be near the other. And in my case, it's my left side. Just a little bit weaker. And that can happen like in a lot of different ways, right? Like you might not know it, but might be just habitually pushing off one leg more than the other when you're doing two-legged stuff. Or even when you're like going up the stairs or pushing on a bike, even though it seems like you're using both legs, like reciprocally, you might not realize how one leg is taking up, they're doing most of the work on all parts of the cycle, or both parts of going up the stairs. All right, so I'm gonna come off of that and work those same muscles, sort of, on the reformer. Foot bar there. Okay, so you can see. So on the reformer, I'll put my foot, the ball of my foot on the foot bar and push out, and then I'm just gonna go ahead and stretch and work those foot and ankle muscles. And then I'm gonna bend my legs and go down and up on my heels. It's kind of an interesting thing to think about. Just isolating the motion to be at the ankle. It's easier on this piece of equipment to accidentally and unintentionally use other muscles to push you up, or other joint movements to push you up, unlike on the chair. And four, three, two, one. All right, and now I'm gonna stand up. equivalent that you would do standing on the playing ground. Where could you see me? Let's put me on top of this piece of equipment so you can see. So I'm gonna bend, and then I'm gonna raise my heels up and down. So that might be how you would do it without the Pilates equipment. There's a lot more going on here, yeah? Because my quads are working a little bit more. Inner thighs are working a little bit more. Glutes should be working a little bit more, but I feel mostly on my quads and my feet and my calves. And three, shaking, two, and one. All right, on to the next kind of movement. So I'm gonna have a seat on the edge here, and sitting on my sits bones, trying to stay completely upright, I'm gonna push down and up high. And if I'm not being careful, this is gonna push me back and forth like this. I'm trying to stay upright still while my legs are pumping underneath me. I'm trying to scoop the energy up into that core as my legs come up. And because I just did all those other exercises, my legs are a-burning. And five, four, three, two, and one. That's one of those exercises that probably doesn't look like much from where you're standing. But if you're doing it right, you feel it quite a bit in your core and your legs. All right. Then, equivalent exercise here. My legs are parallel. I like to do a lot of my Pilates exercises in parallel. Because most people it helps like gain awareness of alignment in when you're working in a simple line. And then I might end up turning my legs out a little bit. I usually start in parallel. So this would be, you know, similar things working as what I was doing sitting up here. It's actually easier because my back is supported, right? So I don't have to worry about holding myself upright with the movement of my legs. I can just feel that my back is in neutral spine and I'm folding at my hips. Four, three, two, and one. And then I'll do the equivalent for what you can do at home without the equipment. All right, so standing here, I'm gonna do some squats. You will notice that I am trying to hinge at my hips as I squat down. And you often get the cue when you're squatting to send your hips back. And oftentimes that gets overdone, like it becomes a real like arch of the back. But I'm trying not to arch at my back. I am trying to just hinge at my hips, keeping this part of my body in the same alignment, just different angle. And then, I don't know if you can see me here. All right. And four, three, two, and one. All right, so now let's work a little bit of this kind of curl motion. This exercise it's called hamstring because you get a stretch in your hamstring. And I also hear people call it washerwoman, which is an unfortunate name, but washer person. Okay, so I'm rounded up and over I'm kind of like an upside down, almost the letter U. And I'm gonna push down and come up. Now, this isn't super heavy. Probably some PTs out there are like, why are you rounding and pushing at the same time? It's not safe for the back. It's not that heavy, and it is quite functional. There are times where you need to, in regular life, when you're not in pain, you need to get out of neutral spine and
into rounded forward. Also a really nice way to activate the front of the body and get move, like activation of the front of the body to allow the back side of the body to get a stretch. Three, two, and one. I'm gonna do a second exercise on here because I am not gonna do one on the floor for this movement. Just not as interesting. So I'm standing on the springs and it's holding my weight a little bit, or my weight is actually holding it down. And then I'm gonna round to come up. So it's kind of like the same motion I just did, but in reverse. And I have to hover so I don't just fall to the ground. And then I'm gonna come up partway and then bend and straighten my knees, hovering up here. People love this exercise because it's so different from what they might do in regular life or at a regular gym, unless you're a gymnast or acrobat. But it is a really nice way to again stretch the back side of you and then get your abs working. And for this, so I was gonna lie down that way, but I'm gonna lie down this way. On this piece of equipment, one of the more fun exercises that is also really challenging is to sit on the edge, the foot bar, and similar to what I just did, scoop up in a rounded position. So I'm just gonna hang out here for a second and just do a couple little leg presses so I can get a feel of how heavy or not heavy this is. My feet are hooked on the edge. And then I'm gonna stand up and round over. And then I'm gonna let my legs slide away and come back up again. This is that same scoop motion that we were doing earlier, requiring a little bit more flexibility and actually, in my opinion, a little bit more control and strength. Two more. This is not an easy exercise, but feels so good. All right, now let's work on opening the chest. We've been rounding forward, now we're gonna work on opening. So on here, I'm gonna adjust the springs. Leaning forward, letting the weight of my body push against the resistance. And then I'm gonna hover in the straight position, letting the bar come up and down, not letting the resistance arch me up. That's what this exercise is right now. So I'm keeping flat. I'm trying not to let my belly hang down, keeping my ribs closed, pressing up towards each other, keeping my legs lifted, just a little energy. Actually, not letting my legs just hang down. And three, two, and one. All right. Then my equivalent here on the reformer will be to, let's see, turn the camera. There we go. On my knees, I'm gonna hold on to the straps and pull. I'm gonna make it a little bit lighter. Just a tad. Okay. So I'm sitting on my heels, keeping myself stacked up, ears over shoulders, in line with my side seams of my shirt. And if I'm feeling up for it,
onto my knees and do the same motion. Keeping myself stacked up, not letting the pressure knock me forward. To hold myself together just enough so that I don't get knocked forward. And four, three, two, and one. All right, back to legs. So on this next one, sometimes you can get a chair that has a arms, like little sticks that come out of it so that you have something to hold on to. I have that here, but I am quite familiar with this exercise, so I think I'll be okay. I have one leg up here, firmly on the surface, and the other leg on the foot bar. And I'm gonna go down and up. The feeling like I'm rising up from my insides. Filling up with air, filling up with helium, and it floats me up to the ceiling, or like little strings attached to my ears, pulling me up to the ceiling. Last one, and we're gonna switch sides. Coming out of under a stage, like I'm in a concert, rising up through the center. And four, three, feeling my whole leg working here, and then using my core to pull myself together to make it easier on my legs. All right. Now something similar on the reformer. You get the pattern. I'm doing, you know, similar movements on the two pieces of equipment. And then, when interesting, showing the equivalent on the floor. So, this looks like this leg is working a lot, and it's working. But the leg that's working the most is my standing leg. I can really feel it on my standing glute. A mirror in front of me so I can make sure that my leg is in nice alignment, hips in line with knees, in line with the toes. If this front leg is bent, the back of this leg is working quite a bit. All right, and then the other side. We're gonna end with what would be the equivalent of that exercise, but if you didn't have the equipment. And I'll do it here, standing on this somewhat stable reformer. I've sprung it up so that it's stable. All right, so I'm standing on one leg, and I'm bending that bottom leg, hinging, and then lifting that top leg up, and then coming up. There's a lot of different ways you could do this. I just went straight to what is more easily available in this piece of equipment that I'm on. And last one. Switch to the other side. Six. Again, the weaker side. It's hard for me to look over the cameras when I'm standing on this leg. It's just less stable. I need a good focus in front of me to not fall over. Three. Not three more. Two. And all right. So those are some exercises that you could do on the reformer. They're somewhat equivalent on the chair and somewhat equivalent on the floor, which I think is nice to see. And when we used to have circuit classes here, that's how we would do them, to share equipment with people. But chairing equipment is not happening these days, is it? So here I am showing all the three different variations of doing, working the same part of the body, but on the different pieces of equipment and on the floor. So I hope you enjoyed that, and I look forward to seeing you guys one day soon here in the clinic or studio. Have a good day.